I was skeptical when I first heard of this title. A Grand Theft Auto title on a handheld? I thought, is that even possible? Of course, at the time, I didn't realize that PSP UMDs were capable of storing like 1.8 gigabytes of memory. This game ultimately just proves how possible a free world sandbox is capable on a handheld system, all with hardly any glitches and hardly any graphical issues. Seriously, playing this game on the PSP is really a magnificent feeling. Driving around the large Liberty City at insane speeds is exhilarating and just rather unbelievable. There are a few frame rate hiccups there, here and there, when you change the radio station of the car which you're driving, but it's not really that big of a deal, at least it wasn't to me. The rendering, considering the fact that this is on a handheld, is shockingly impressive, even though the draw distance is comparably lower than you would expect from like a PS2 GTA. Graphically and technologically speaking, Grand Theft Auto Liberty City Stories is pretty much a masterpiece. Down to the little details like flat tires or broken glass, two NPCs' interactions with you will make you reconsider. Is this a PS2 game or a handheld game? The game runs smoothly and looks beautiful while doing so. The only unfortunate thing is that this game is really taxing to the battery life of the PSP. Even on power save and on the lowest brightness settings, the PSP can't handle this game for like longer than like 4 hours. After that, poof, it's gone. So you just gotta, it's almost like as soon as you start the game, you get sucked into it. That's when the PSP just goes like, I have no more battery life. Sorry, bye bye. Now, as for gameplay, the controls are great, which is hard to say for majority of PSP's action game catalog. Driving in this game is actually a lot more fluid and easily accessible compared to the other GTA games. I don't know what they did with the physics, but they made it a little more arcadey and a little more easier, actually, to drive around. And on this PSP system, I think that's actually a good thing, because the analog nub is just not as fluid and responsive as, you know, the analog stick of the PS2 controller or the Xbox controller. I guess they, you know, so with one analog they have to work with, you know, they had to make do with better, I guess, easier physics. And they were right to do so. Now, this doesn't mean that every vehicle drives the same, and once you play the game, you'll actually notice how each vehicle drives and handles differently, showing how much effort went even to the littlest detail of the game. There are various missions, but one disappointing thing is that all the mission structure is more linear than any GTA game I ever played or seen played. Because I didn't play Vice City, but I did watch it pretty much played, like a playthrough video on YouTube. And I know how those missions are. Vice City actually looks pretty damn awesome. Gotta play that someday. Anyway, now I'm digressing. Now, the missions in the game, in this game, Liberty City Stories, you go to other people's houses or offices to get your mission. And a lot of times, there will only be one single place to go on the map at a time. So if you fail that mission, well, you have to do it again. You don't really have an option to another mission and come back. You're not really given a chance even to tackle multiple missions at once, and that was really disappointing. But the variety of missions was fairly nice, even though some missions were ridiculously monotonous, and some missions were just unnecessary. Seriously, like that mission where you butcher a man, literally, with a butcher knife, just to prove to my mom that I'm more manly than that guy? Man, that made me feel really bad for doing that mission. I know GTA games are supposed to be controversial and kind of jump to the moral gray or the morally bad side of things, but that mission just made me feel horrible and I didn't want to do it. But again, it's a video game, so and it's supposed to go beyond the limits. And for the GTA Liberty Series Stories, doesn't have as much shock value, I guess, as the controversies that you will encounter in many other GTA games, but that mission in particular was just like, wow. The title of the game is misleading, though. The title of the game is Grand Theft Auto Liberty City Stories. Now, yes, it's a Grand Theft Auto game set in Liberty City, alright, but where are the stories? Actually, let me fix that. Where is the story? Aside from the great dialogue, there really is no incentive to keep on playing the story missions, because they're so devoid of any kind of plot or interesting circumstances. There is absolutely no cohesion for the story. You know, and even though as comparatively, I hated Grand Theft Auto 4's realistic, boring story, but that had cohesion, that had a plot. With Grand Theft Auto Liberty series stories, not really. So the cutscenes in the game, they're kind of entertaining to watch, but as a whole, they're still really disappointing in the game. It's really better not to watch them at all at certain times. The characters can be boring and weird, and sometimes not a good weird. The story is non-existent, and the missions are just there to be played, and when you try to understand them, you'll be left with a huge void that you just can't fill. But of course, who plays GTA games for story, I guess? I mean, I sometimes do. But with Liberty Series stories being actually pretty fun with the missions, and you playing this game on the handheld, which always, you know, that kept it fresh for me, just the fact that I'm playing on the PSP. So, for GTA fans, this game is really cool to play. But for those wanting the full GTA experience, I do have to remind that this is a handheld port of the series, and it all sometimes shows. Going from Grand Theft Auto San Andreas to Grand Theft Auto Liberty Series stories is similar to going back to Grand Theft Auto 3. You can't swim, there are no airplanes to fly, there are a huge lack of special vehicles and special missions, and the abilities of weapons is really lackluster. It just feels, at times, like a downgraded version of Grand Theft Auto. And while that's understandable, for gamers who never experienced Grand Theft Auto and want to know what it is all about, this is not the game to start with. This game is just good for fans who want to experience the greatness of GTA on the road. And at that, it does a fantastic job. But the game is not without some major flaws, as I have already mentioned in this video.